He actually applauded it. He liked it. He even sent them a message congratulating them on their Grammy nomination. Although they did not win it, it was still one of their highest points. What do you think?
Well, with regards to In the Air Tonight, because of me growing up when I did in the 80s, I was a huge Phil Collins fan. I even had the vinyl. I'm sure that will thrill you.
Yes.
But I was the biggest Phil Collins fan all through the 80s. Until. I heard the story, and apparently it was true, that Phil Collins met up with a former flame of his, maybe somebody from his high school days, college days, I don't know, but a former flame of his, and he decided he was madly in love with her. He had lost out in that part of his life and sent his wife via a fax machine message that he wanted a divorce so he could go be with this love of his life. Well, the love of his life was married. And when she got word that he was professing his love to her, she was like, dude, I don't feel that way for you. It was great seeing you, but no, there's no future for us. And for whatever reason, ever since I heard that story about Phil Collins on how he treated his wife, I forgot of how many years, and about how he was such a slime bag coward and approaching the idea that he wanted a divorce, I lost all respect for him. Wow. And ever since then, I would never listen to any of his music. And anytime I ever heard it on the radio, I would change the station. I just lost that much respect for him. So, with that being said, though, in listening to Nonpoint's version of the In the Air Tonight, I actually liked it. Now, again, I know the 80s version, like Inside Out, but I really liked the In the Air Tonight by Nonpoint. I applaud them on them doing a really great remake of that song.
Well, I can't agree more. I like it because it's, you know, it's heavy. The only thing that I think I can say is wrong with the remake is I think the drummer came in just too soon on the bum 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 bum. I think that was just a little too soon, but you know, it is what it is. I mean, it's a heavier tune than the original version, and yeah, I mean, I still jam both versions of it whenever it comes on the radio. Now, after that was one of your favorite songs, I know. Because, I mean,
Not Cars, it's The Cars.
That's what I say.
No, you said Cars.
Oh, whatever, Cars.
No, it's The Cars. You show proper respect right now as you claim your elders, okay? So you show proper respect. But no, it is The Cars by Rick Ocasek, and who is absolutely one of the greatest. But yes, Drive has always been...
My apologies to Rick Ocasek.
Okay, good. Thank you. But no, I have always loved that song, Drive. It's like it just stops me in my tracks, and it's like I want to start swaying back and forth and holding my imaginary cigarette lighter up in the air, swaying with the flame going off, which is kind of funny because now... You know,
it's
cell phones with the lights going off versus the cigarette lights.
Which I guess makes the fire marshals very, very happy now versus back in the
70s
and
80s. We're wanting to, you know, encourage the younger youth not to smoke like the older people did or do. I'm all for the flashing the flashlight from the cell phones in the air as you're swaying back and forth, but... My heart will always pitter-patter, you know, thinking about my days going to concerts in the 80s. And even though I've never smoked a cigarette in my entire life, I would have a cigarette lighter to flick my thumb and have the flame going in the air, swaying back and forth.
Yeah, but when you had a friend that smoked and they didn't have a light.
I'm sorry, but I didn't have friends that smoked.
I had friends that smoke that, plus other things.
I understand.
So, what about the Deftones version?
Well, like you said earlier, I actually really love the Deftones, and I actually really do like the Deftones version of Drive. So, it's like if I didn't know the 80s version of the song Drive, I would really love the Deftones version, but I can actually chill and relax to both. I really like them both, so I commend them both.
I feel the same. Now, I'm with all the songs that we're playing tonight, there's a lot of songs that I wanted, or we wanted to play tonight, and I wanted to play some Prince covers. And since there's not very many metal bands out there that do Prince covers, although Corey Taylor does, he does perform three. And if you don't know who Corey Taylor is, well, he's the son of a bitch that sings for the band Slipknot and Stone Sour. Now, I'm fixing to show Kim for the first time Corey Taylor performing one of her very, well, yeah, one of her favorite
all-time favorites.
Kiss songs.
Besides, excuse me, who?
Not Kiss. Prince. I saw something. I saw a word that said that had Kiss, and
you're thinking of Prince's song Kiss. Good God!
No, I actually saw a word on the screen that had Kiss on it, and I read it as I'm speaking. But anyway, a song from Prince besides "Let's Go Crazy," "Little Red Corvette." And I'm going to show her this. Hopefully, you guys can hear it through the mic system. I'm not sure, but let's let Kim, for the first time, get a reaction of Corey Taylor performing "Little Red Corvette."
You know you are jacking with one of my favorite songs.
In a world where so many people treat music like a commodity, it was always refreshing to know that there was always Prince. It was always. He may be gone, but goddamn it, we have a.
He doesn't scream. He doesn't scream any
of it. Oh, for once, he doesn't scream.
No,
and sound like a total ass.
He's really good at singing, but okay. Just listening.
Okay, let's see.
I wasn't sure if I was going to do this or not, but I'm going to give you a little song. This is one of my favorite Prince songs.
This was recorded also the day he found out about Prince's death, which is on the day it came out. Okay, so that's basically the whole song. There's like two more choruses, I think. But what'd you think of that?
Well, for once, you actually found a Corey Taylor song that I can actually tolerate.
Only because you know it and love it.
Well, I love the song with all my heart, but for once, I can actually appreciate Corey Taylor, because every other song I have ever listened to of Corey Taylor that he's done a remake of, I literally just gag. And I'm sorry, it's just not my cup of tea, but he did a wonderful job in honoring the incredible, fabulous, Love With All My Heart, Prince. There will be no one else ever like Prince.
Well, not ever will there ever be another artist like Prince, because the dude played 22 instruments.
And he wrote his own lyrics.
He wrote his own songs.
And he played all the instruments. And I'm sorry, but a lot of these so-called artists today, they can't do shit. I mean, they can maybe sing, but they can't write lyrics. Or they can't play a tune on any kind of instrument. I mean,
The only pop artist today that I will give credit to for writing their own songs, and this is a rare for me to say, is Taylor Swift.
Well, I was going to say, you better say Taylor Swift.
She's the only one that writes her own songs, even though they're shitty songs.
No, don't go there.
Well, there's a couple of songs that are good.
Yeah, I was going to say, I know for fact you like some, so don't even try to lie to your audience. Do not make your audience think that you don't have a soft side of you as well.
They ought to know, because last week I played fucking New Kids on the Block.
Oh, well, they suck! Are you kidding me?
Shit, New Kids on the Block kicked ass back in the day.
Oh, what? That's in the 90s, dude.
No, they came out in 87, thank you.
What? No.
I got CDs and records.
They were little. They were barely wet behind the ears. They haven't even really hit puberty yet. They were
No, only one of them had barely hit puberty.
Oh, Lord. 1987, I was in college. I could have cared less about New Kids on the Block.
Yeah, I was 9 in 87.
Shut up.
All right, so you have opinions about...
Okay, so back to what the music we originally played. Yes, in the air tonight, I do commend both Phil Collins and Nonpoint. I am just now, it's taken all these years, just now getting to the point that I can listen to Phil Collins again without utter disgust. Drive, of course, Drive is one of those songs that it doesn't matter what kind of mood I'm in, doesn't matter where I'm at, what I'm doing, when I hear the Cars version of Drive, I literally just stop in my tracks, and I just like have to almost like sway and go into another world of listening. But I actually like Deftones version, and as you know, I like Deftones, so I commend them both for their great remakes of these songs.
This is a message out to my guitar player, Johnny O. Hey, let's cover this song, but make it a death metal song.
Oh, God.
Let's do Drive from the Cars.
Do not fuck with that song. Are you kidding me?
Who's going to drive you
home? No!
Tonight!
I will go to your shows, and I will cuss at you the entire time. Do not mess with what is great.
Work on it, Johnny.
No!
All right. So, next you're going to hear couple of other songs. They're the same songs. Me and Kim will be right back after this. We're coming up to the closing of the segment, but you're gonna listen to People Are People from Depeche Mode and Dope. I'm pretty sure she's gonna say something not cool about Dope, because she doesn't like Dope.
No.
The substance and the band.
Don't mess with perfection, and Depeche Mode did it.
I like both versions of this
damn song.
I think Dope did it better, but...
No.